the forest. It can roar loudly. It eats meat. Lion is the king of the forest.
Lion is an animal. It lives in the forest. It can roar loudly. It eats meat. Lion is the king of the forest.
Greedy is cursed. Once upon a time, there was a dog. He was very hungry. He got a piece of meat. He reached at a stream. He saw his reflection in the water. He thought another dog with a piece of meat. He wanted to get it. He opened his mouth. He lost his own piece of meat.
The clever hen. One evening, a fox catch a hen. But the hen was very clever. "Please let me go. I have a music competition tomorrow," said the hen. "No, I will not let you go," replied the fox. "Then I will sing it now," said the hen. "Okay," the fox agreed. "Will you sing it me? This is my last wish," pleaded the hen.
The goose that laid the golden egg. A man and his wife had the good fortune to possess a goose which laid a golden egg every day. They soon began to think they were not getting rich fast enough, and imagining the bird must be made of gold inside, they decided to kill it to get all precious metal at once. But when they cut it open, they found it was just like any other goose. Thus, they neither got rich all at once, as they had hoped, nor enjoyed any longer the daily addition to their wealth.
The goose that laid the golden eggs. A man and his wife had the good fortune to possess a goose which laid a golden egg every day. They soon began to think they were not getting rich fast enough, and imagining the bird must be made of gold inside, they decided to kill it to get all precious metal at once. But when they cut it open, they found it was just like any other goose. Thus, they neither got rich all at once, as they had hoped, nor enjoyed any longer the daily addition to their wealth.
Hi, I am Grandma Sajid. Good morning. The nightingale and the rose. She said that she would dance with me if I bought her red rose, cried the young student. "But in all my garden there is no red rose. From her nest in the oak tree, the nightingale heard him as she looked out through the and wonder. No red rose in all my garden," he cried, and his beautiful eyes filled with tears. On what little thing does happiness depend? I have seen all that the wise man have written, and all the secrets of philosophy are mine, yet of one of
frost is my life name, Richard.
I am Ashwinas. A soothing song. In Russia, there lived a rich merchant. He had a servant, a bright and brave boy called Ivan. The merchant was a cruel man. He made Ivan toil from dawn to dusk. Ivan had no time to rest. Tired after heavy work, Ivan would lay on his bed. Then a nightingale would start singing sweet song to him. Every night the nightingale used to sing for him. He could never see the nightingale as it was dark outside, but its song soothed him to sleep. What a lovely song! How beautiful it sings! But what is the meaning of its songs? I wish I could understand the language of birds.
The language of birds. In Russia, there lived a rich merchant. He had a servant, a bright and brave boy called Ivan. The merchant was a cruel man. He made Ivan toil from dawn to dusk. Ivan had no time to rest. Tired after heavy work, Ivan would lie on his bed. Then a nightingale would start singing sweet song to him. Every night the nightingale used to sing for him. He could never see the nightingale as it was dark outside, but its song soothed him to sleep. What a lovely song! How beautifully it sings! But what is the meaning of its song? I wish I could understand the language of birds, Ivan would think. Thank you.
Ivan. A long time ago, there was lived a boy named Rodney in a village. He was very happy with his family, but his happiness could not last for long. Rodney and his fellow villagers faced a severe drought. They desperately wait for rains, but with no luck, all the crops, land, and even trees dried up. The cattle started dying. As there was no rain, the stream was drying up slowly. One night, during a meet with the villagers, Rodney said, "Friends, we all have heard tales from our grandparents about an underground river flowing through our village. Why don't we dig and see?" The villagers agreed and started digging. They dug for some days but gave up soon. However, Rodney kept on digging. When people told him to give up, he said, "God is helping and guiding my way." One day, when he had just dug enough, Rodney saw water. His attitude of not giving up saved the whole village. Never give up so easily, Rodney advised all the villagers. Now they are never short of water, and whenever any problem arises, all the villagers came up together and find a solution. Thank you.
My home. Everybody called me Raja. It is not my real name, but I liked being called Raja. I lived with my grandfather and grandmother. They were my guardians. My mother died when I was young. My father left me with my grandparents who brought me up. We lived in a large house, but we were a small family. There were grandfather, grandmother, uncle and I. We had many relatives, but they lived in their own houses. Grandfather was a tall, strong man. He always spoke in a loud voice. He knew everyone in the village. People respected him. They came to him for advice and help. Grandmother was kind and gentle. She took good care of me. She would follow me like a shadow, saying, "Drink this milk, or eat your food, or have your bath, or go to bed." I did not like this, but still I loved her very much. My uncle was young and very clever. He helped grandfather in looking after his fields and gardens. People liked him, and I too liked him very much. Whenever I was in trouble, uncle would come to my help. Thank you.
एक बार वह नाले पर पानी पीने गया।
कर उसने सोचा, इस मेमने का मांस कितना अधिक कोमल और स्वादिष्ट होगा। मुझे इसे पकड़कर अपना भोजन बना लेना चाहिए, उसने मेमने से कहा। तुम पानी को क्यों गंदा कर रहे हो? मेमना बोला, श्रीमान जी, पानी आपकी तरफ से बहकर मेरी ओर आ रहा है, फिर मैं इसे गंदा कैसे कर सकता हूँ? धन्यवाद।
नमस्ते सबको, मेरा प्रणाम। बेटिया और मेमना, एक मेमना था। एक बार वह नाले पर पानी पीने गया। जब वह नाले पर पानी पी रहा था, तभी वहां एक बेटिया आ गया। वह भी नाले पर पानी पीने आया था। मेमने को देखकर उसने सोचा, इस मेमने का मांस कितना अधिक कोमल और स्वादिष्ट होगा। मुझे इसे पकड़कर अपना भोजन बना लेना चाहिए, उसने मेमने से कहा। तुम पानी को क्यों गंदा कर रहे हो? मेमना बोला, श्रीमान जी, पानी आपकी तरह से बहकर मेरी ओर आ रहा है, फिर मैं इसे गंदा कैसे कर सकता हूँ? धन्यवाद।
नमस्ते, मेरा नाम ज्ञानानंदी है। सच्चे मित्र, किसी गांव के बाहर एक पीपल का घना पेड़ था। उस पेड़ पर एक कौवा रहता था। पेड़ के नीचे बिल में एक खरगोश रहता था। कौवा और खरगोश दोनों पक्के मित्र थे। दोनों साथ साथ घूमते फिरते रहते थे। कौवा हमेशा खरगोश को हिंसक जानवरों से बचने के उपाय सुझाता था। गांव के पास ही एक जंगल था, उसमें एक सियार रहता था। वह खरगोश को खाना चाहता था। वह सही मौके की तलाश में था। एक दिन कौवा पेड़ पर बैठा था, अचानक उसकी नजर सियार पर पड़ी। वह पेड़ों के आसपास घूम रहा था। कौवा उठकर तुरंत खरगोश के पास गया और बोला, धन्यवाद।
देवांगनायम मसे लौटो। सच्चाई का फल। एक जंगल में एक बाघ रहता था। वह खतरनाक जानवर था। वह अक्सर गुफा को में रहा करता था। भूल लगाने पर वह गुफा से निकलकर बाहर आकर जंगल में चरने के लिए आने वाले पशुओं पर हमला करता और मारकर खा लेता था। थैंक यू।
नमस्कार सबको, मेरा प्रणाम। मैं टेबोल। एक हाथी था। एक दिन वह नदी किनारे घूम रहा था। नदी किनारे उसे पिंगू नाम का एक खरगोश मिला। खरगोश हाथी को ही देख रहा था। खरगोश हाथी के पास आया और बोला, हाथी दादा, आप बहुत महान हैं। आपकी चाल भी निराली है। काश मैं आपकी पीठ पर बैठकर सवारी का आनंद ले सकता। उसकी प्यार भरी बात सुनकर हाथी बोला, मेरे नन्हे दोस्त, इसमें कौन सी बात की रुकावट है? तुम अभी मेरी पीठ पर सवारी कर सकते हो। हाथी ने पिंगू को अपनी पीठ पर बिठाकर जंगल की सैर करवाई। पिंगू को उस दिन बहुत मज़ा आया। ऊंचे ऊंचे पेड़ों पर लगे फल जो उसे ललचाते दे, आज उन्हें छूकर वह फूला नहीं समा रहा था। शाम को जब उसका दोस्त बबुआ बंदर मिला तो उसने हाथी की सवारी के आनंद के बारे में चर्चा की। बबुआ बहुत शैतान और मुँह का कड़वा था। पिंगू की बात सुनकर बबुआ के मन में भी हाथी की सवारी करने की इच्छा हुई। अगले दिन वह हाथी के पास गया और बोला, ए मोटे, गा पीकर इतना मोटा हो गया है, कुछ काम कर। धन्यवाद।
नमस्ते, बुरी संगति। किसी गांव में एक व्यापारी रहता था। उसका एक ही पुत्र था। वह पढ़ने लिखने में बहुत तेज था। वह माता पिता और अपने शिक्षकों का आदर करता था। उसके माता पिता और शिक्षक उससे प्रसन्न रहते थे। कुछ दिनों के बाद लड़का बुरी संगति में पड़ गया। वह घर से विद्यालय पढ़ने के लिए जाता, लेकिन रास्ते में रुक जाता। वह अपने दोस्तों के साथ शरारतें करता और घूमता फिरता रहता। कभी कभी वह जुआ भी खेलता। वार्षिक परीक्षा हुई तो वह फेल हो गया। लड़के के माता पिता बहुत दुखी हुए। उन्होंने पुत्र से फेल होने के कारण पूछा। पुत्र ने झूठ बोलकर उनकी बात को टाल दिया। एक दिन उसके पिता जब बाजार से लौट रहे थे तो उन्होंने उसे कुछ बुरे लड़कों के साथ जुआ भी खेलता देख लिया। थोड़ी देर बाद जब लड़का घर आया तो पिता ने समझाया। लड़के ने कहा अब वह बुरे लड़कों के साथ नहीं रहेगा। दो तीन दिन लड़का ठीक समय पर विद्यालय गया, किंतु बाद में वह फिर उन्हीं बुरे लड़कों को साथ खेलने लगा। धन्यवाद।